In the world of fashion, you're either in or you're out. On the hit reality series Project Runway, you just never know what to expect. Take a look.
Each of you has the potential to make real impact in this industry. So, we're throwing out the rule book.
What are you doing?
What? Just talk, please.
Designers, at this moment, we plan to let all of you show at New York Fashion Week.
Yay! I'm excited for them all. Joining us now from Project Runway are three of this season's four finalists. Please welcome my friends, Sergio, Geoffrey, and Nancy. And I'm screaming because one person's going to walk away with what?
A lot of money.
$250,000. So you guys are all my besties, but one person is more of my bestie than others. But I can't be in your presence being all regular, so I have Fancy Nancy trying to get me ready to be in your presence because I can't be plain when I'm in, like, up in here, right? Yeah. So we're going, what are we doing, Nancy? We're going from day to night.
Day to night. You are set to go.
That's right. It's as if I planned it.
There you go.
I love that. That's a moment.
Of course it is a moment, St. Sergio. All right, so I am like, I look fancy now, but I'm one of the little people because you guys have been graced with some great celebrity judges. I'm going to go out on a limb and say that one of your biggest moments was with Cyndi Lauper.
Yeah.
Am I making this up?
Yeah, no, it was a big moment for me. She's an idol of mine, so yeah, I won that challenge. Yeah.
Of course you did. Yeah, what about you? What was your highlight? Which celebrity did you...
Laverne Cox is such an advocate for not only the trans community, but she represents so many beautiful communities. And I'm always trying to push the narrative of making a change. And she's somebody that does make a change every single day she wakes up. So I'm so inspired by her.
I'm inspired by Nancy. So who inspired you, Nancy?
Well, actually, for me, my moment was when Project Runway became non-existent, and it was my client, my Paralympian, Tatiana McFadden, the wheelchair user.
Oh.
That changed my life as a person, as a designer forever.
This is a life-changing show to be on, because everyone's a winner.
Yeah.
In some way, shape, or form, right?
Yes.
But look at Christian Siriano. Like, look at the heights he's attained since, like, was it season four? It's unbelievable.
Yeah.
So how has this changed your life so far? And if you win the $250,000, aside from making me your bestie, what are you going to do with the money?
I want to change the world. Honestly, I want to make a great impact, help people, and just inspire people that they can make a change with what they love.
What about you?
I need to pay my mom back some money.
Oh, mom's mostly rooting for you then.
Yeah. But mostly, I just got to get my company up and running and make sure it lasts.
Nancy, aside from taking me shopping from all fancy Nancy outfits, what are we doing?
I've been hearing from people throughout the world and with adaptive design, wheelchair users, disabled, senior communities. And I feel like there's a reason why I got to do the challenge and there's a reason why I should be doing this, and that money will get there.
All right, so we have some of your designs here. For people who are not keeping up, they have something special about them that brought them to the final. So this is your look, and I'm your model. Tell us about this.
Well, this is actually a men's coat.
I can still be your model.
Yes.
Seriously.
Yeah, actually, a man or a woman, I do like playing with androgynous clothing as well. And I think this color palette would look fabulous on you.
Mm-hmm, that's right. All right, so we're going to move over. Well, let's talk about this one.
It's a jopper sleeve kind of, dress. It squeezes in a lot at the waist. I'm really into the jopper shape right now on sleeves and a keyhole opening.
You had me at squeezing at the waist. Because I have been holding my breath since I walked in here. I'm going to let out later, but I can't even barely breathe. Ooh, this is fancy.
Yeah. This is one of my signature fabrics I use, and you look at it, it's just amazing and magical, liquid like organza. But I use this as my inspiration for what you'll see on tonight's episode. Mm-hmm. You've seen a sneak peek. I've adapted this design to make it fully accessible for a wheelchair user.
So we have two more episodes to go?
Yes. Mm-hmm.
Our hearts beating like
nonstop? Crazy.
Blood pressure high?
Yeah.
How are we surviving this? How are we keeping the secrets from your family members? Because your mom probably wants to know stuff and you can't tell her stuff.
Yeah. It's mostly we'll find out on the 12th is what I just tell people we'll find out on the 12th because I don't know either.
All right. So we're from different areas, some closer to us than others. You're from?
I live here in New York City.
But where are you originally from?
Austin, Texas.
Texas.
Yes,
that's right.
Representing Texas.
Brooklyn, New Chicago. York.
Philly girl.
Oh,
Philly
that's
girl.
Right. All right, so I am already counting what I want to do with the money. Whatever you want to give me, I'll take, so you know. I'll just move in with you guys.
Yeah.
There you go.
You said you live in
Bushwick.
New York and Chicago?
Yeah, Bushwick now, Chicago 15 years ago.
Oh, okay, so I have a home in Philly, Bushwick, Chicago, and Austin, and in New York. That's right, five homes. You can check out all these fashions and all these finalists on tonight's episode of Project Runway on Bravo. I will not be there. Back to you guys.
No, and you also have one home, the one you currently live in. They are not inviting you to their home. You are not welcome. They're running out of the studio. Okay.